Hi everyone! Welcome to my very first video where I talk, and I'm so excited to start talking in my videos. I've gotten so many requests from you guys telling me to start talking in my videos, so now I finally am. So let's begin! These are the materials you will need. You're going to need a crocheting hook, a pair of scissors, yarn in any colors you like. I'm using 28 acrylic yarn balls. And in this video, I'm wearing an adorable bracelet from BornPrettyStore, and I got a coupon code for you guys to use on their website. So let's begin crocheting. So you're going to begin by making a slip knot. Then put your hook through the slip knot and make 88 chains. Now you can make less or more chains depending on the size of your neck area. Then you're going to flatten out the chains you made, just to make sure that everything is straight. To combine the two ends, you're going to make a slip stitch. And now you're going to make 3 chains up. Then into the chain next to the 3 chains, you're going to make 2 double crochets in the same loop. After you made the 2 double crochets, make 1 chain. Now you're going to skip 3 chains, and into the 4th one, you are going to make 3 double crochets. And then after the 3 double crochets, you're going to make 1 chain. And those 3 double crochets are called a shell. So you're going to make 10 shells. Now after you made the 11th shell, you're going to chain up 2 instead of 1 like we made earlier. And then you're going to make 3 double crochets into the same loop as you made the 11th shell. And this will make the corner of the poncho. And always remember to chain 1 after each shell. And then just continue with the same technique as earlier and make 10 more shells. And then once you reach the other end after the 3 shells, you're going to make another corner just as before. Chain up 2 and then 3 double crochets into the same loop as the one before. Now you're going to join the loops together and you are going to slip stitch until you reach the big loop on the side. Once you've reached the big loop, you're going to make 3 chains up. And then you're going to make 2 double crochets into the big loop. And now you're just going to basically repeat the same steps over and over again until you reach the desired length of your poncho. So all you're going to do is make 3 double crochets into all of the big loops. And then you're going to make, and then you're going to remember the 2 corners where you make 3 double crochets and then chain up 2. And then 3 double crochets into the same loop and then slip stitch across, 3 chains up and make 2 double crochets, and then you're just going to repeat. So just repeat the same steps over and over again until you reach the end. Thank you. Now there's a lot of ways to change colors, but the easiest way I know how to do is by cutting off the yarn you are using, and then you're just going to tie a knot with the yarn you want to use next. And this is the easiest way I know. There's a lot of ways to change colors, so you can do it in any way you like. And I am going to change colors after every second row. And then just cut off the excess and continue crocheting. Now if you're going to use a thin yarn, like I'm doing right here, I would suggest you use two yarn balls instead of just one, so it will be a lot thicker. And after crocheting for a few hours, you're going to get a lot better at this, and you can even crochet while watching a TV show or before bed. It's going to get really relaxing, and it's a lot of fun to do. And all in all, I made 23 rows. And then for the last row, you're just going to make the slip stitch like earlier. And after making the last slip stitch on the big loop, you're going to remove the yarn from the loop and from your hook. And now you're just going to tie a lot of knots. I'm going to tie about 4 to 5 knots just to make it very, very secure. And then definitely try it on to make sure you know how big you want to make your neckline. Now to make the neckline, it's really easy. You're just going to make single crochet. So take it with your hook through the loop, make one stitch, and then you're just going to make 3 single crochets into the big loops. and then you're just going to make one in the small loops. And then just continue crocheting until you reach the other end. But remember to go back to the beginning of the neckline and use the string we left and tie several knots with the string we left in the beginning of the poncho. And now you're just going to make one slip stitch. And you are going to chain up one and then just continue single crocheting until you reach your desired length for the neckline, and just go through every hole, every loop, and make single crochets. And then when you're done, just tie several knots again. And since I used two yarn balls for the neckline, it's really easy for me to make the knots. So you're just going to go through some of the loops we made earlier and tie the two strings together. So I do recommend use two strings for the neckline. Also, it's a lot warmer if the neckline is a bit thicker. And then just cut that off. And now this is optional, you can make tassels as well. So you're just going to fold the strings into three. Then cut off on the end there, as well as two sides. And then you're just going to fold it in half, put it around your finger, and then through all of the big loops on the bottom of your poncho. So just put the tassel through the loop and tighten it. And then you could also trim the ends to make them straight. And that's it, guys. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video and my very first voiceover. Tell me in the comments what you think about this DIY. I would love to hear your comments and respond to you guys. And Pinky really loves the poncho. So thank you so much, guys, for watching. And here are my last two videos. Bye, guys.
Diba dito?
Okay. Hindi nakikita ang mukha mo, mama. Ano yan? Mga PG.